Hey guys, I'm John and welcome to Respect Your Intellect. In a couple of videos now, we've talked about some of the quantum effects that happen at very small scales, but we didn't dive fully into the details of each. In this video, I'll introduce this new quantum effects series and some of the effects we'll be covering very soon. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons, and let's get started! In science, we pretty much separate the world into two areas. One is classical physics, which is all orderly and expected at the large scales, and the other is quantum mechanics, which is all random, unexpected, and based on probabilities at the molecular scale and below. In the quantum world, there are a lot of phenomena that take place routinely that are very different than what we experience every day as we interact with the world in classical physics. There are a few effects that I want to present in this introduction that we'll be covering in this series. Let's start by imagining that we're holding a ball in one hand and that we live in a quantum world. Now, let's imagine that we throw the ball one time and instead of going towards the wall, hitting it, and bouncing back to us as it does in classical physics, it simply disappears from our hand, appears at the wall, and appears back in our hand without having traveled between our hand and the wall. Well, in the quantum world, this happens all the time, and it's called quantum jumps. Every electron that surrounds an atom will be jumping like this at the different orbitals of the atom as the atom absorbs and re-emits energy. Now let's throw the ball again, but this time it doesn't hit the wall where we were aiming. Instead, it hits the wall way off to the side, which is nowhere near where we were aiming. Well, this also happens in the quantum world because as the ball leaves your hand, it starts behaving like a wave of probable locations of where it will end up. So the further the wall is, the wider of an area the particle can actually end up. Just like a single small rock dropped in water will eventually make waves as large as your house. In this example, the probabilities made it so that the ball hits the wall well beside the area that we were aiming. This is the wave-particle duality of particles in the quantum world, where everything travels like a wave and only collapses with an interaction with the outside world. This phenomenon is called quantum superposition, where a particle is everywhere it can be simultaneously. Another example of superposition is Schrodinger's cat. This thought experiment consists of a box that has a vial of poison inside that's set to disperse at any random moment, and a cat is put inside. Once the box is closed, the cat can be thought of as both alive and dead simultaneously. It's only at the very moment that you open the box that you'll find out whether the cat is alive or dead. Now back to our example with the ball. Let's say we make another throw, but now instead of bouncing back to us, it simply goes through the wall. Well, again, this is something that happens frequently in the quantum world. It's called quantum tunneling. The chances of a particle getting through depends partly on the thickness of the barrier. This is one of the reasons why we can't really continue to make transistors smaller in computers, because the electrons will simply tunnel through them if we do. Next, let's imagine that we both have a ball, and that if I spin mine clockwise on my finger, yours starts turning exactly the opposite of mine counterclockwise, and it does this instantly, even if we're separated by huge distances. So essentially, your ball knows to turn counterclockwise faster than light could have traveled to it to transfer that information. Well, this is another quantum effect that happens very often, and it's called quantum entanglement. Furthermore, quantum entanglement can be used to essentially teleport particles to a remote location without having to physically send it, which we call quantum teleportation. So this was just a quick and simplified overview of some of the quantum effects that we'll be covering in this series. There's a lot more to each than we just talked about here. That's why we'll have videos dedicated to each effect so we can cover them properly. There's also more quantum effects than the ones we just talked about, so if there's a lot of interest in this series, we can always dig deeper in other quantum effects and how they work as well. So I'll leave it at that for now, and I'll see you on the next video where we'll cover our first quantum effect in detail. If you have any suggestions about science topics or recent science news that you'd like me to cover, don't hesitate to write it down in the comments. For more interesting science content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell notification so you don't miss out on anything. You can also check out my website at respectyourintellect.com for all the information and videos on this channel. Until next time, thanks for watching, and remember, respect your intellect.